Hi guys, hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. This is PM Biology and I am Punya and I am a biology lover. So we are going to discuss about the same topic, that is sexual reproduction in flowering plants, but we are going to go for a new topic, that is the part 6 of it, that is pollination. Okay, so you can click on the iCard which is there on the YouTube screen over there in the right hand corner for the previous videos related to this pollination. So today's topic is pollination. So first we need to know what is pollination. So pollination is the process of transfer of pollen grains from anther to stigma of the pistil. Whether it is from the same flower or different flower does not matter. So transfer of pollen grains from anther to the stigma of the pistil is called pollination. I'm repeating it again. Transfer of pollen grains from anther to stigma of the pistil is called pollination. There are three types of pollination in your course. They are autogamy, genogamy, and it's gytnogamy. So these are the three types of pollination which we are going to talk about. Three types of pollination. So now we are going to talk about the types of pollination. So we are defining the three types of pollination according to the sources of pollen grains. That means from where the pollen grains have arrived. So first we will be talking about the first type of it, that is autogamy. Auto means self. Auto. Meaning of auto is self. So, self-transfer of pollen grains to the stigma of the flower. So, let's define it. Transfer of pollen grains. I am mentioning it as PG, that is pollen grains. So, transfer of pollen grains from anther to stigma of the same flower. Example, it's pea plant, rice, etc. So transfer of pollen grains from anther to stigma of the same flower. Self means same flower. The concept is same. Wherever pollination is there, we have to talk about transfer of pollen grains from anther to the stigma. But here when we are talking about this auto, that is self. So here it's same flower. Example is pea, rice. Too many examples are there, but in your book, that is NCERT, two specific examples have been cited. So it's pea and rice. So second type of pollination is gytnogamy. This word gytno means another. So transfer of pollen grains to stigma of pistil of another flower of the same plant. When we discussed about autogamy, it was same flower of same plant. But gypnogamy is different flower of same plant. Example is cucurbita. You can say it belongs to cucumber family. Hence, it is called functionally cross-pollination because it is not taking place for that same flower, same plant. It is taking place between different flower of the same plant. So, it is functionally cross-pollination, but genetically, it is self-pollination because it is taking care in the same plant. Now, it's the third. The last type of pollination which we are going to talk about, it's gynogamy or allogamy. It's totally different flower, different plant. So transfer of pollen grains to stigma of the pistil of another flower of the different plants. Okay. So if we can account for plant A and plant B, so transfer of PG, that is pollen grain of plant A, this is totally different to the stigma of plant B. So this is your gynogamy. Example is papaya and maize. So next topic is about cross-pollination. You must be knowing about cross-pollination and self-pollination. Cross-pollination is transfer of pollen grains within different plants. So cross-pollination means transfer within different plants. Okay, so transfer of what? Same pollen grain to stigma. Okay. So, what are the devices used for cross-pollination? So, in your course, there are two terminologies. One is cleistogamous and the other is homogamy, which will be accounting for this cross-pollination. Cleistogamous. Cleistogamous means, this word cleisto means it's closed. So, it's a bisexual closed flower. So these plants, the cleistogamous plants would be having bisexual flowers, but they would never open up. That means they will be never having anther exposed up. Closed flowers means anthers not exposed. Okay? Example, you have to remember the example, it's Commelina. I don't know the common name for it. Just Google it. You are very friendly with Google, you can just Google it. It's Commelina. So, cleistogamous flowers, it's the best example where cross-pollination can take place. Cleistogamous are what? They are bisexual closed flowers. That means anthers are not exposed in that. Example is Commelina. Next device by which we can account for cross-pollination is homogamy. Homo means self. So, what is in that same plant we are talking about but with different flowers? So, anther and stigma mature at the same time. So, the condition is that, the condition for homogamy to take place is that the anther and stigma should be mature at the same time. For example, it is taking place in Mirabilis plant, that is also called 4 o'clock plant. That means the flower would be rising at just 4 o'clock. So next we are talking about same topic, that is devices for cross-pollination. But in this we are talking about how self-pollination can be prevented. In the previous few minutes, I had discussed about how we can favor cross-pollination. Now we are talking about how self pollination can be prevented. That means for the same plant, same flower, how we will be stopping the transfer of pollen grains to the pistil of the pistil. So see here, first it's chasmogamous. Chasmo means open up. That means here bisexual flowers are there, but they are always in an opened up form. That means they are having exposed stamen and anthers. This is the first condition. Second is unisexuality, or we can say dioecious condition. That means dioecious condition is favored by plants in which the male and female flowers are separate. For example, you can take for hibiscus. For papaya you can take for. Okay, dioecious condition. Male and flower, female flowers are separate. Next, self incompatibility. When we were favoring for cross pollination, we talked about the incompatibility only. But here it is self incompatibility. That means anther and stigma will not mature at the same time. So that's all for today's class. So here the part 6 is over, where we discussed about pollination and types of pollination depending on the sources, and how we can go for cross pollination and how we can prevent self pollination. So in the next video I'll be talking about essence of pollination. So just wait for it. Till then, please like, share and subscribe my channel so that I can reach to maximum people. Thank you.